Yo, what's going on YouTube? Welcome back to another Minnesota Twins trade rumors video. That's right, it's been a while, but I got a good one for you today. As you saw in the title of the thumbnail, the description, we have Matthew Boyd and Shane Green from the Detroit Tigers. Now, I do think this is very unlikely for a couple of different reasons, but it is one of the trades that I know a lot of you guys have talked about in the comments that you want to see my opinion on, or you want to see, you know, why this could be a good trade. So of course I'll give you my opinion, I'll give you the stats, I'll give you why it could be a good trade and why maybe it isn't. So let's just jump right into it. I'm going to give you my opinion right away. I don't think this is a great trade for a couple of reasons. One is it's an interdivision rival, and as much as I think that, you know, Detroit, Kansas City, they're tanking, they're on the way out, those are bad teams, I just don't see them giving the Twins the competitive edge, right? It's the same thing for Bauer from Cleveland. I really think Bauer could be a guy that, you know, we could use. Not that we would go get him, because again, I don't think we need that kind of player, but I just don't think they'd trade him to the Twins because it's that interleague rival and they don't want to help them out for some reason. I mean, there have been trades in the past, you know, that have done that, but I just don't see Detroit doing it with the Twins simply because of the next couple of reasons, I guess. And the second reason would be they want a lot for Boyd, and Boyd is not a bad pitcher by any means. He's got one of the best FIPs in the entire league, again, on a very bad Detroit team. Shane Green along with it. I think this has only been, you know, a combination or package deal. But specifically for Boyd, he has been very, very good. And I just don't know how much teams are willing to give for him, you know, because like they've come out and said, we want XYZ for him. We are not just going to trade, you know, Nick Gordon or Miguel Sano or Adrianza straight up for him. Like, they want pitching, they want prospects, they want a lot of stuff to help them build for, you know, the next year, which is understandable, right? If you've got a pitcher that you're wanting to get rid of course, you want to get something in return for him, especially when he's a caliber like Boyd is, right? I mean, what is he, 24? Is that, scroll down. Is that what he is, 24? He's 28. Okay, my bad. He started in 24, or he started as 24. But, so 28 years old, very young still. Green, again, he's 30 now. So there you go. They want to get these guys out to good teams, but they want a lot back in. I don't think the Twins are really able to give them that. And then the last reason is I don't think we need a starting pitcher. So I know that I've said this before. I know a lot of you guys agree. We need bullpen help. And I think if we just went after Shane Green, that might be a different story. Same with Ken Giles, even though he is kind of part of the Stroman deal. You know, there are options, and I'm not going to say that, you know, we shouldn't go after or explore these other options. But from what I've seen, it's a package deal, and I just don't think we want to give up something for Boyd just to get Green. You know what I'm saying? So I don't think we need a starting pitcher. Our starting pitchers have been good. Our bullpen has struggled. Our offense has struggled. I really think that those are the pieces we need to work on, not starting pitching. Of course, you know, we could always put Perez in the bullpen. I've given that as an option, but it doesn't look like they're going to do that. So I just don't see it happening. I'll give you the reasons why we should go out and give these guys a chance, though. You look at Boyd. Look at him. He's got a WAR of 2.7. That's very good for a pitcher this season. I mean, it's basically half his WAR for the last, whatever, 5 years that he's played? 6 years? 5.5 years that he's played in professional ball. Half his WAR is coming this season, so that's pretty good. 6-8 record, probably the best on Detroit. I mean, they're a bad baseball team with an ERA of 4.13. But again, you can't really look at that because it's Detroit. They kind of suck. But in 20 games, you know, 120 pitches, he's got he's got 160 strikeouts. Very good. I mean, that's not quite two per inning, but 1.5 for sure. Very, very good. He's got, like I said, one of the best FIPs in the league. If you don't know what that is, it's fielding independent pitching. It's a 3.5. Very good. I mean, you could just look at a bunch of different stuff. strikeouts to walk ratio is 6.67. Very good. He doesn't walk a lot of people. 160 strikeouts to 24 walks, and that's leading the league. So I mean, he's definitely good. He gives up, you know, a hit or walk per inning, but that's fine. I don't think anybody's complaining about a WHIP of 1.1. Very good player. You know, it's just what would we have to trade for him? Let's go to Shane Green a second. Shane Green has been in the league for 6 years. He's 30 years old, as I mentioned. I wouldn't say struggled the last couple of years, but again, on a bad Detroit team. He was an all-star this year. Let's just go through his stats. Okay, he's got a WAR of 1.4. Compared to his career, a WAR of 1.5. If you can do math, that means he came into this season with a WAR of 0.1. And that is not good. But he's really done well this season coming out of the reliever role. He's their closer, isn't he? Maybe I'm wrong. Yeah, he is their closer. He's their saver. And he's got an 0-2 record this year, but his ERA is very good. 1.25. If you look at his FIP, it's 3.8, which is still good for this season. Again, anything under 4 is very good for the FIP. In 36 innings, he's got 40 strikeouts, a WHIP of 0.8. Very good. I think I honestly think if the Twins wanted to go in this direction, they could. And this would be a good trade if they were willing to give up that much for him. And now I want to transition into what we could give up for him. I know they don't want, you know, guys like, let me just throw out examples like Jonathan Scope or CJ Krohn or somebody's like that, because they're trying to build for the long term, right? We all know that. That's what teams do with the trade deadline. Same with the Giants. Even though they've done well as of late, they're a team that struggled at the beginning of the year. Their manager's out the door. You know, their Bumgarner's on his last leg. There's a couple other guys that are on their last legs. They're going to try to rebuild, right? That's what you do. And you're not going to want these guys like Scope, who's on a one-year deal, or Krohn, who's on a one-year deal, or Cruz, that's on a, you know, one- or two-year deal. So, not that we would trade those guys anyways. I'm just saying they're going to want young guys. I don't even know if Nick Gordon falls into that category. And we've already limited ourselves with, like, is Thorpe on the no-trade list? I think it's, like, Thorpe, Lewis, there's two pitchers, Larnach and some other guy, and then Kriloff. Is that it? I don't know. I think that might be it. There's like four or five guys in the no-touch list, and I'm pretty sure Detroit would specifically ask for those guys, if anything. I mean, those are, what, number 4, 8, 17, 50 prospects right there. They're really good, especially in the Twins, you know, organization. They're very good. I just don't see them wanting to get rid of these guys, but these guys could fit into our role. Like I said, if you did want to move Perez to the bullpen, you've got a spot open for Boyd. Then we could always use another reliever. I mean, I think we are the front runners. I've heard today that we are the front runners in the Will Smith trade from the Giants, which would be great. We need another lefty arm if Thorpe, you know, doesn't go. I really think Thorpe is capable of being another left-handed arm out of the bullpen, but if we need one more, you know, Smith is an option. Green, who has, 22 saves this season? 22 saves this season, 32 last season. He's been very good. He got 18, like, all 18 wins that Detroit had at the beginning of the year, which isn't much from what they have now. What are they, like 28 and something? But yeah, they're bad. He had like all 18 wins, saves, you know what I'm saying? Like all 18 games were decided by the save. So, I mean, these are guys that could definitely fit into our rotation. You know, we just sent down Littell to bring up Thorpe. More than capable of getting rid of a bullpen guy. I mean, Asadillo could be out the door. If we wanted to bring in another pitcher, there's a couple of other guys. You know, Duffy is good, but is he the guy we need? Same with, you know, May or anybody else like that. We've opened up some roster spots. There's a lot of different moves we can make in the bullpen that could invite these guys in. I think the main question is what would we have to give up, and it's too much for Boyd and Green. But definitely options I think we could look at. I do like this option more than Baumgartner or Stroman and Giles, but I definitely think that it's just too much for the Twins. Not that they don't have money. It's just that they don't want to give up their players for the next couple of years. Because a lot of our guys are on one-year contracts for this season, maybe next season, and then they're out the door. Maybe retiring. You know, they're getting old, 33, 34. Scope's up there. Crone is up there a little bit. So you've got these guys that are going to be out the door in the next couple of years. And we have guys in our system that are good. It's just, if we trade them, we start from scratch if we don't, you know, do well this year. And that's a big red flag to me. So that's all I got for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I definitely want to know your opinion on Boyd and Green. I want to know what you think. I want to know who we'd have to trade for him in your opinion. So let me know down in the comments below. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks so much for watching. Game review tonight. But if you guys enjoyed the video, leave a like, subscribe, check up the video right above my head. If you missed it, and we'll see you later tonight for the game review. Peace out.